In this segment, we'll talk about the individual neurons that make up the three-neuron chain for fine touch and proprioception. So neuron number one, of course, as always, lives in the DRG. Its peripheral process is going to be in the skin, and it's going to project a central process into the dorsal horn. It doesn't synapse here. That's the big thing to remember, and it doesn't cross the midline. So it passes through here. It may make it may give some information to some of the neurons around here via what we call an axon collateral, but that's not its main synapse. It's going to ascend on the same side in the dorsal column. Okay? The dorsal columns are divided. They have a regional specificity. So the fasciculus gracilis is here, and the fasciculus cuneatus is here. Gracilis is going to be concerned, it's going to be carrying fibers from your lower extremity and part of your abdomen. Okay. The way I remember gracilis is that there's a big muscle in my thigh called the gracilis muscle. And so I always put gracilis and gracilis together. The fasciculus cuneatus is over here. It's a little more lateral because if those axons that are coming from the arm are going to enter on their way up after the ones in your leg have entered, okay? And the way I remember cuneatus as being my upper extremity and my thorax is cuneatus kind of goes with cuticles, which are, you know, around your fingernails, so it's upper extremity. You'll figure out a way to remember it for yourself, I'm sure. The second neuron in the chain is in the medulla oblongata, and there is a nucleus. There's a gracilis nucleus and a cuneatus nucleus, and that is where all of the axons from the fasciculus are going to, gracilis are going to synapse here, and the axons from the fasciculus cuneatus are going to synapse in the cuneate nucleus. So you have two divisions of that dorsal column, gracilis for the leg, cuneatus for the hand and arm, and you have two nuclei, the nucleus gracilis and the nucleus cuneatus, where those tracks are going to end. This neuron is equivalent to that neuron in the dorsal horn of your spinal cord for gross touch. So it's going to cross the midline. So its axon crosses and then ascends. We call these fibers, as they're crossing, the arcuate fibers. Once the arcuate fibers have crossed the midline, we call this band of fibers that's ascending the medial lemniscus. I can't even spell. So let me clear this and draw it a little more neatly. There's a nucleus, nucleus cuneatus, nucleus gracilis, where their specific tracks end. Neurons cross the midline. These are the arcuates, arcuate fibers. I have to remind you that a lot of these fiber tracks and things were named before they knew what they were doing. Not that the anatomists didn't know what they were doing, but they didn't know exactly where the fibers were coming from and where they were going to. So they named them arcuate because it's a curve, it's an arc. They then ascend in the medial lemniscus. And this is the second neuron here is the one again that's going to talk to the neuron in the thalamus. So fine touch and proprioception, third neuron in the chain, just like gross touch, is going to be in the thalamus. And the thalamus, the neuron in the thalamus, then projects to primary somatosensory cortex. And again, that is your post-central gyrus. So in the next sections, we'll go through and draw this pathway a couple of more times just to solidify it. And then at the end, we'll kind of summarize what the big differences are between gross touch and fine touch so that you get those straight in your mind, because they're important diagnostically, and we'll talk about that a little bit at the end.